Like, subscribe and press the bell icon for more videos from PHN Learn. For more videos, download our app on the Play Store.
Hello and welcome to PHN Technology Private Limited. In today's session, we are going to learn about operators. Now, the moment I told you operators, you basically have judged that this is something about related to math. Now, in maths also, we have done operations, right? Like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and etc. So, that similarly, here also, these operators are nothing but my symbols, which does these operations, these kind of operations. Okay. Now, in my C programming language, there are multiple operations. And so, there are multiple operators. Right, because operations are done by only operators, right? So now there are different types of operators, right? So here, for example, arithmetic operators, relation operators, assignment operators, logical operators, bitwise operators, shift operators, unary operators, and so on. These are my some main operators, right? And with these also, there is another concept of conditional operators that we will see later on. Okay. So now, these operators are used for doing the operations. Right? So now what happens is, let's take an example of arithmetic operators. Now from the name only, you may have judged that this is something to do with addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, which you have already done in your maths. Right? So that is similar over here also in your C programming language. If you want to, these arithmetic operators hold which operators? Like addition, minus, that is subtraction, division, mod, right? These are the operators which it holds. Multiplication also. These are the some operators. These are five operators which my arithmetic operators holds, which it holds. Okay. Now, if I'm relating this to math, in math you have learned the concept of Bodmer's rule. What was that Bodmer's rule? That was nothing but bracket of multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction. Right? This was the same. Right? So now this Bodmer's rule was invented by, we learned this rule to judge the what is to be taken first, to judge the priority of the operators, of my arithmetic operators, right? Like, let's take an example here. I have an expression that is 20 plus 10 into 10. 20 plus 10 into 10. So, in this operator, in this operation, in this expression, I have two operators, that is my addition and my multiplication. Now, what comes first? Because, see, this expression, it doesn't have any parentheses over here. It doesn't have any brackets over here. Then how will I understand that which expression, which operator should I get first? Should I give the first priority to? Right? That will be a question mark for me. And for that reason, we have generated a Bodmer's rule. Now, here if I applied that Bodmer's rule, then what will happen? Here, first my Bodmer's rule says what? First, the priority should be given to multiplication, bracket of multiplication, division, and then addition. So, firstly, in this expression, I will do the multiplication of the two operands. Right? That is my 20 and 10. 10 and 10. Then, whatever will be my answer, that will be added to my this operand. And this is how I sorted the expression. I got my answer. That's what I needed, right? The correct answer. And I got it. How? Because of my Bodmer's rule. Because it showed me what is my priority. What should I get first? What should I evaluate first? Right? So now in my C programming, what happens? This same Bodmer's rule is replaced by a new terminology that is nothing but precedence. This BODMAS is replaced by my precedence. Precedence is nothing but it shows what is the basic higher priority of the expression. Precedence levels work same as my BODMAS rule. Here also, multiplication will have the highest priority, then division, then addition, and then subtraction. Okay, so this is how my precedence level works here. Right? Now, in this also, in precedence level also, there is some limitation. So what is it? Now, I have seen that multiplication, division, then addition, subtraction, but let's consider this is multiplication, division, and this is my addition and subtraction. But both multiplication, division, as well as addition and subtraction have the same precedence level. See, these have the same precedence level. Then now, if in a expression like this, here I have an expression that is 20 minus 10 and then again plus 10. Okay. Now here I know that addition and subtraction have the same precedence level. Then now what will I do? I will solve this expression. This expression doesn't even have parentheses. That means the brackets, right? So now then how will I get the highest priority? Right. So now here comes the logic of associativity. This associativity is a parameter which shows me that if in an expression you have two operators which have same precedence level, then what you should do. In arithmetic operators, the associativity of arithmetic operators is left to right. Means in this expression, I will move from left to right. I will start solving the expression because this expression have the same precedence level. These operators have the same precedence level, right? So now what will I do? I will move from left to right like this. And then I will solve the equation. And I got the correct answer. Right? So this is how your associativity works. So this is a basic concept, like two parameters, that is my precedence level and my associativity. These are the two parameters which are very important while learning your operators in C programming language. Okay, now this was all about your arithmetic operators. Now every time remember one concept, that is operators. What do you understand by operators? We know that operators are nothing but my symbols, like this. These are my some symbols, and those symbols are known as operators. Now, whatever operations it will perform, means addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, these are my operations which are performed by my operators. These addition, subtraction, multiplication, these are known as my operations. Whereas the values, that is, let's say 2 plus 3. Now, my plus sign is my operator, whereas my 2 and 3 are my operand, because that operation is performed with those two values, and hence those are known as operands. Every time remember these terminologies. Okay, this was all about your arithmetic operators. Now, let's proceed to relation operators. Now, from the word only, you have made judge that relation means that should consider some relations over there. So, relation operators are like this: equal to, less than equal to, greater than equal to, and so on. Right? So, these relation operators also have the associativity. These relation operators also have the associativity of from left to right only. Like, let's say for an example, here I have expression like 2 is greater than or equal to 3. Okay, so here the associativity property will be from left to right only. First it will read the left operand and then it will compare it to the right operand. It will go from left to right. Okay. So these were the relation operators. Relation operators, you know, if you want to compare certain operands, that is certain values, is it greater than this? Is it equal to this? This is not equal to this. Then we use my relation operators. Okay. Now, again, there are some assignment operators. Now, assignment operators means, in C programming language, we use equal to equal to. Means what? Or simple one equal to. Here what happens is, if I consider equal to, then what happens? Then I am directly giving one value. Let's say, consider for example, here I have n is equal to 20, and then I have again declared a new variable, that is m. Okay. Now I want to store n value to my m variable. Then what will I do? I will directly store it. How? Through assignment operator. I will store it like this. And every time, remember, in C programming language, the associativity of assignment operator is from right to left. And so, if I want here, what will I want? I want that n value should get stored to m value. Then, and I also know the associativity is right to left. Then I will form an expression like this. Here, what is happening? The right value is first read, and then its value is getting stored into my m. N value is getting stored into my m. Right? So this is how your assignment operators work. Its associativity is different from rest of the operators, right? It is from right to left. Okay. Now comes with the logical operators. Now logical operators are what? These logical operators are basically used when you want to compare, you want certain specific condition over there. Let's explain this in detail. Okay. Now, these logical operators, consider AND, OR, NOT. These logical operators are what? These logical operators are my AND, OR, NOT. These three are my logical operators. Let's first consider AND. Now, AND is represented as this. Ampersand, ampersand. Twice ampersand. Now, every time while working in your logical operators, remember that logical operators give a Boolean expression. It gives the result in Boolean values. It evaluates the expression in Boolean, that is true or false. It only has two possibilities. Either it will be true or else it will be false. It doesn't have any other values. Okay. Now let us consider AND here. I have considered AND. Now in AND what happens that if at all you have two trues. Now, two trues means double one. Because true is evaluated as binary one and false is evaluated as binary zero. This is very clear, right? Now, true means AND. AND is if at all you have two true values, that is two one value, then it will give me the answer as true, that is one. This is the condition of your AND, and if at all this condition is not true, like let's say in the second value, that is 0 and 1, here I am getting 0. Why? Because I have told you that AND what requires two trues. Means if I have considered two expression over here, then both my conditions should get true value only. If at all one condition gets false and another gets true, then this will not give me a true value. This will give me false value only. So like this, the truth table of AND is formed. See, here also 001, 000, 100. This is my truth table of AND. Okay. Now, this suppose it is my OR. What happens? OR tells me what? If at all there are my any, if at all OR, there are my only one, at least the condition is what? If at all there is at least one true value, then also it will give me a true value itself. Right? What happens? like this the truth table will form me. If at all it is 0, 0, then it will give me 0 because there is no true value. And my condition of or is it should get at least one true value. Okay, so here it will be 0. Then it will be, if I consider 1, 0, then it will be 1. Because here I am getting at least one true value, right? Then again 0, 1, then again 1, then again 1, 1, then also 1. Because here I am getting 2 ones and I have considered at least 1. So if more than 1, it is also fine, right? So here also true value. And OR is represented as double straight lines. Okay. Now comes an NOT, that is my negation. NOT is very simple. NOT is what? If you have a certain value that is true, then it directly gives me false. It converts the value into false value. That means if you have one, let's say true value, that is binary 1, then it will give me false. It will negate it. It will give its negation there and it will give me a false value, that is 0, binary 0. And if at all you have a false value, then it will give me reverse, that is 1. Okay, it reverses the value, it reverses the Boolean expression. NOT, and NOT is represented as negation. Okay, so this is how your logical operators work. Logical operators are basically worked with if else condition, where you have to satisfy a condition. Now you have got the clear idea what I was telling, right? That means it is basically used to satisfy a condition. Okay. Now these were your all operators. Now remaining are your bitwise, shift, condition, right? So in the later session we will see all these remaining operators. Okay. Before that, you should always, we have learned the associativity, right? But what if, let's say in a expression, I have a mixture of all the operations, means all the operators. Means here, I have, let's say this is my expression. Now in this expression, all the operators are mixed. But I haven't seen this, right? I haven't learned the precedence level of these expressions. Then how will I solve the expression? And now none of the associativity will also work. Because till now we have learned only a particular operator associativity and a particular operator precedence level. But what if I combined it? Then what? Every time remember your operators also have a your precedence level, and this is it. Your postfix and your prefix are my first. Those have the highest precedence level in your operators concept. And then similarly here, unary operator, and then so on. This is my table which shows the precedence level of your operator. And now through this table I can solve the expression. I will first evaluate that which operator have the highest precedence level. Then I will take that operator, solve it, and so on. Like I have done in arithmetic operator, right? So this was all about your operators. In later session we will see the remaining operators too. Okay, so for now, for today, this was your today's session. For now, thank you and goodbye.
For more videos, download our app from the Play Store.